What's up guys? In this tutorial, I will show you how to fix the issue when you are unable to hear any sound or partial audio while using OBS Studio on your PC. This should be quite an easy tutorial. For more information, click on the first link in the description below. Open up OBS and in your audio mixer, make sure that your volume slider is allowing audio to pass through. I would suggest setting the mic slider to -2 dB to prevent audio clipping. When this is done, click on the gear icon for your microphone and select Properties. On this window, change the device to your default sound input device. This will allow OBS to pick up sound from your default audio input device, which will be set by your operating system. Next, click on this gear icon again to access your advanced audio properties. This panel will allow you to change the overall volume of the audio source, add a sync offset, and most importantly, change the audio monitoring option. In order to allow OBS to pick up the sound as well as hear it while recording or streaming, set this option to Monitor and Output. I prefer to set my desktop audio to Monitor and Output and my microphone to Monitor only. This will allow me to hear the desktop audio and OBS will record my mic audio input. In case you still have audio issues after applying these changes, then make sure to navigate to your OBS settings window. Here, in the Audio tab, set your sample rate to 48 kHz if you can. Under Global Audio Devices, I like to set my desktop audio and mic sound input device to my default Windows device, as this option will change automatically when my default device changes for Windows. In some cases, you will want to set this option to a specific input or output device, such as a dedicated streaming microphone or your headphones for your output device. When all of this is done and you still have audio issues, then your problem might be related to an outdated audio driver or to other programs running in the background. First, to update your audio driver, search for Device Manager in your Start menu search to open it up. Here, expand your audio inputs and outputs. Right-click the audio output device you are using and select Update Driver. Finally, click on Search Automatically for Drivers. This will take a second to make sure that your audio driver is up to date. You should also complete this step for your microphone and other used audio devices. When this is done, you can close your Device Manager and open up your native Windows settings. Under System, select Sound. Here, make sure to set the correct audio input and output device. Your volume should also not be muted, and below, you have the option to troubleshoot common sound problems for your audio input and output device. This will take a minute to check if there are any common issues with your selected default audio device. Next, click on More Sound Settings. This will open up your sound control panel. Under Playback, make sure that your default device is enabled and disable all other devices for now by right-clicking each and selecting Disable. Next, right-click your enabled device and select Properties. Under Levels, make sure that the device is not muted. In the Advanced tab, you should also check both of these exclusive mode options. You can then close your sound control panel and your window settings. Lastly, you should prevent programs from running on your PC, which could change your audio devices while using OBS Studio. To do so, search for Task Manager in your Start menu search to open it up. Here, in the Processes tab, right-click the programs which could change your audio device's properties and select End Process. In case nothing helps you out, then you will have to uninstall and reinstall OBS Studio to your system, preferably to another drive. Before uninstalling the application, open up OBS. Under Profile, select Export. This will allow you to export all of your scenes and import those again when the new install is ready. Restart your PC after making all of these changes. In case you have any further issues or problems following this tutorial, then I suggest following my extensive guide linked in the description below. I hope this helped you out. Leave a comment if you have any questions, and see you in the next.